and welcome to the Thinking Out of the Box Instructional Dance video series. Today we are going to learn about dance therapy and movement studies. We're going to learn about who all is involved in dance therapy along with where it all began. What is the real meaning behind the unusual form of dance therapy? And also explore some fun applications in our society. Well, first you may ask, what is dance therapy?
I don't know, Bekah. What is it?
Dance therapy is the therapeutic use of movement to improve the mental and physical well-being of a person. It focuses on the connection between the mind and body to promote health and healing. Dance therapy is considered one of the most expensive forms of therapy. Dance therapy is also known to the public as movement therapy. Dance therapy is the psychotherapeutic use of movement and dance for emotional, cognitive, social, behavioral, and physical conditions. As a form of expressive therapy, dance movement therapy is founded on the basis that movement and emotion are directly related. The ultimate purpose of dance movement therapy is to find a healthy balance and sense of wholeness. Organizations such as the American Dance Therapy Association maintain the high standards of professional and educational throughout the field. This form of therapy, which is taught in a wide array of locations, goes farther than just centering the body. Specialized treatments of dance movement therapy can help cure and aid many types of diseases and disabilities. Now you may ask, who exactly does dance therapy?
That's an excellent question, Bekah. There are just a few different cases in different patients that dance and movement therapy treats and helps. One of the many cases that this special type of therapy helps is autism. The specialized dance therapists connect on a sensory motor level, provides a sense of acceptance, and expands skills and cognitive abilities. It also increases maturity. Another case that it helps is with learning disabilities. Dance therapy helps people with this type of disability develop better organizational skills, learn and experience control and choice, have higher self-esteem and confidence, and gives them new inspirations to learn. One case it also aids is mental retardation. It helps improve body image, social skills, coordination, motor skills, and it promotes communication. There are many different groups of people that dance and movement therapy also brings together and treat. One group of people is deaf and hearing impaired persons. It reduces feelings of isolation and provides inspiration for their relationships. Along the same lines as this sensory deficient group, it helps the blind and visually impaired. It improves body image, motor skills, and personal awareness. Well, what about physically handicapped? Dance therapy improves motor skills and body image and helps provide a way to communicate and express emotions. Dance and movement therapy also helps the elderly. It provides social interaction, expression, exercise, and alleviates fear of loneliness and isolation. Dance therapy has been found very effective for people living out their lives in nursing homes by providing opportunities for freedom of expression through movement. Many of these older people regain more positive attitudes about themselves as well. It also helps people who have eating disorders. It alters distorted body images, which helps end destructive behavior and helps discover symbolic meanings behind the disorder. Parkinson's disease victims also use dance therapy. This type of therapy uses rhythm to help reduce body dysfunction and improves motor abilities, balance, and the use of the limbs. Well, now that we've talked about adults, what about the babies? Dance therapy also aids in birth preparation. It employs relaxation techniques to reduce anxiety, learn breathing techniques, and release energy. It builds confidence to help cope with labor, birth, and early childhood development. Dance therapy not only helps the individual with motor skills, exercise, and coordination, but helps build confidence, self-expression, and gives hope to others that there are people out there just like them dealing with the same problems. It also helps those who want to express themselves.
Thank you, Lindsey, for that inspiring message of who all dance therapy affects. Now you must be thinking, well, where did it all start, Melissa?
Well, Marion Chase was known as the Great Dame of Dance Therapy. While teaching dance, she realized that her students cared more about expressing themselves and their emotions than they did about doing the technique correctly. After sessions with her, they said that they felt a feeling of increased well-being. Marion Chase was the first president of the American Dance Therapy Association, which was founded in 1965. But before that, in 1942, a nearby hospital psychiatrist heard about this and asked her to come and work with their patients in dance and exercise. And by the 1950s, the hospital used dance movement therapy as a serious medical treatment. Another important pioneer was a therapist named Trudy Shoup, who was born in Zurich, Switzerland, and moved to America in 1934. She mirrored Chase's work and used dance movement therapy on patients with schizophrenia. In 1903, in England, at the age of 12, Margaret Morris began to create and teach her own dance movement therapy exercises to students of all ages. After participating in her exercises, her pupils began to show signs of stronger bodies, greater movement, stronger bones, and increased lung capacity. Rudolf Steiner's therapeutic eurythmy has a deep philosophical and spiritual basis. His core movements connect to the sounds and rhythms of language and music, and to emotions, and create free artistic expression. The use of music, color, and written sources, such as poetry, are important, though pieces are sometimes performed in silence. The rapid early growth of dance movement systems by the 1930s had given way to the modern dance therapy movement developed on principles established by Rudolf Leben, who was a dancer and choreographer and had a system of observation and notation of dance movement called effort shape. Leben's system has been very widely used in dance movement therapy. Audrey Weathered, a private student of his, used his teachings with psychiatric patients, maladjusted and psychotic children, and people with learning difficulties. Veronica Sherbone used therapy based on Leben's system with psychiatric patients in the 1950s, and in 1965 she made a film called Movement for Mentally Handicapped Children. Dance movement therapy that we think of today started in about the 1970s and 80s when American psychological therapists began to experiment with the psychotherapeutic uses of dance and movement. From their experiments, dance therapy became known as a form of psychotherapy.
Now, I think that is all very interesting, but let's find out why dance therapy is important. On to Mandy!
Okay.
That was dorky.
According to the American Dance Therapy Association, dance therapy is often used as part of the recovery process for people with chronic illnesses. Dance therapists work with both individuals and groups, including entire families. There was a recent discovery by neuroscientists of mirror neurons has launched a spark of scientific investigations. This is very important to the therapeutic process of dance movement therapy. As an interactive phenomenon, studies have revealed that when someone witnesses a performance, they mirror the same actions or emotional expression as the performer. This can be demonstrated as a way to improve hand-eye coordination of babies in early development, as does this little boy who mirrors all the single ladies' music video. Coordination at a young age by listening to music. So how does dance therapy work? According to a therapy consulting group known as Inspires, dance therapy is based on the premises that the body and mind are interrelated. Dance therapists believe that mental and emotional problems are often held in the body in the form of muscle tension and constrained movement patterns. They also believe that the state of the body can affect attitudes and feelings, both positive and negative. Dance movement promotes healing in a number of ways. Moving as a group brings people out of isolation, creates powerful and social and emotional bonds, and generates the good feelings that come from being with others. Moving spontaneously helps people learn and to recognize and trust their impulses and to act on or contain them as they choose. Moving creatively encourages self-expression and opens up new ways of thinking and doing things. On a purely physical level, dance therapy provides the benefits of exercise, improved health, well-being, coordination, and muscle tone. And on the emotional level, it helps people feel more joyful and confident and allows them to explore such issues as anger and frustration and even loss that may be too difficult to explore verbally. It has been proved in the Western world that dance therapy provides a unique approach for the psychological treatment. It is especially helpful for those patients who cannot express their mental problems effectively by language, so that they express themselves through body language. The dance therapist can effectively observe, communicate with, and then treat their patients. Also, according to Inspires, dance therapy has a broad range of health benefits. It also has been demonstrated to be clinically effective at improving body image, self-esteem, and attentiveness. In addition, it can enhance the functioning of the body's circulatory and respiratory systems. Proponents of dance therapy claim that it has also been used successfully to help people deal with brain injuries, AIDS, arthritis, amputation, stroke, cancer, and a number of physical ailments. Now I'm going to show you some of my special dance techniques, like the running man. Thank you, Mandi, for those important facts. Now on to Kyle with the applications of dance therapy.
Thank you. Dance and movement therapy can be seen in psychiatric hospitals, clinics, special schools, rehabilitation facilities, and even daycares. You can even get a job as a dance therapist. Postmodern dancer Anna Halperin has worked with people suffering from AIDS, cancer, and other life-threatening diseases. Training to be a dance therapist not only requires a background in dance, but also training in psychotherapy. Dance therapists can use this unique technique as a variety of uses, from treatment to expressing themselves with physical communication. As a patient, your dance therapy experience will depend on the illness that you're trying to deal with. Whether you're working with a dance therapist in private practice or as the context of a dance team. And naturally, different dance therapists have different styles. You need absolutely no previous dance training to benefit from dance therapy. You will meet with a dance therapist in a dance studio, and the therapist will talk to you about your needs and your reasons for wanting treatment. Next, the therapist may ask you to walk around the studio in order to analyze your body shape, posture, and movements. Is your body erect, or is it slumped over? Do you reach out or hold yourself in? Do you move in a fluid or restricted way? Finally, the dance therapist will discuss your treatment goals with you. Your dance therapist will watch you dance, encourage you, and express feelings throughout movements, and also try to help connect your thoughts, feelings, and memories with your movements. Dancing is fun and it feels great. It can even be used as a stress reliever. Dance therapists also address specific problems in specific ways. For example, to help a patient reduce stress, a dance therapist would first identify how the person's body reacts to stress, then explore specific movement techniques to increase circulation, deepen breathing, and reduce muscle tension. This guy developed a technique known as awareness through movement. This technique has been used as a tool for healing injuries by using early childhood coordination, breathing patterns, and attention to the patient's body movements with more efficiency. The whole point of these movements are to focus on finding the ease and efficiency in movement patterns. There are several other techniques used in movement therapy, such as Berentice Fundamentals and the Alexander Technique, where students learn how to move using the least amount of tension. Simple movements such as sitting in a chair, walking, and lifting their arms are practiced with the teacher's hand guiding the movements. Dancing is for everyone, and you don't need a partner to do it. You can dance if you wanna. You can leave your friends behind, because if your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, then they're no friends of mine.
This concludes our Out of the Box instructional dance video series. Stay tuned for our next episode.
Dance. We can dance if we want to. We can leave your friends behind. 'Cause your friends don't dance. And if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine. I say we can go where we want to, a place where they will never find. And we can act like we come from out of this world, leave the real one far behind. And we can dance.
He's a little protective of his microphone, I can see.
Your bleacher's methanol takes up all of her time.
Cope with labor, birth, and early parenting.
Well, Marion Chase was known as the great dame of dance therapy. If we want to, we can leave your friends behind. Cause your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine. See, we can go where we want to, place where they will never find. And we can act like we come from out of this world, leave the real one far behind. We can dance.
And so am I. And we can dress real neat from our hands to our feet and surprise them with a victory cry. Say, we can act if we want to. If we don't, nobody will. And you can act real rude and totally removed, and I can act like an imbecile. Say, we can dance, we can dance. Everything's out of control. We can dance, we can dance. They're doing it from pole to pole. We can dance, we can dance. Everybody look at your hands. We can dance, we can dance. Everybody's taking the chance. Safe to dance. Oh, it's safe to dance. Yes, it's safe to dance.
Hey, people walking by the window staring at me. Would you like to learn about dance movement therapy?
It's philosophical. That's what it is.
This is safe to
dance. Yes, it's safe to dance. Dance. It's a safe dance. Oh, it's